take any questions. If anyone has any questions. Is this a weird?
No.
Okay, hopefully you guys can hear me. Okay, so we got one question here.
Because black bears don't do very well with grizzlies, what does it mean to the spirit bear that the grizzlies are more abundant on grizzlies or off?
Yeah, so I guess, yeah, I mean, for us it was a bit of a challenge that grizzly bears are leaving the mainland and now going over to the islands and starting to take over some of the habitat. And we've seen some rivers where we would go to, I mean, I remember 10 years ago going to these rivers and you would just get 100% of black bears and spirit bears and all day this amazing blooming. And then a grizzly bear shows up there and it just changes the whole landscape, and now these bears would come out for 5 seconds, grab the fish and run back in the bush. We've heard stories where grizzly bears would sometimes attack the black bears, so it definitely changes their behavior and how they come out. And so it's not something that we really want to see, but it's the shift that's happening. And you know, to me, I think it's because of the huge decline in salmon numbers that these grizzly bears are leaving the mainland systems and now going over to the islands in search for more food resources. But again, I think that's going to be another research project we're going to have to do, but that's why we want to continue doing some of that work for in the next few years. Questions? Morning. Christina, where's Christina? You want to answer that question?
You want me to answer that?
Sure, you can.
We're actually just at this turning point of population. We're just at the turning point of population estimates. So although it seems like it should be very simple bean counting and counting bears on the landscape, we actually need quite a few years of data. So we're hoping that after this year, this winter, we're going to be able to start to do some population estimate work. Up until now, it's been more than we're fun looking at.
Any other questions? Yep.
Yeah. First of all, thank you, Joan, for welcoming me to Salish Territory. Thank you, Salish Territory. Given the recent Supreme Court decision for the Honeywood team and the Chilcotin people, given more control of the resources within First Nations territory, is there any present discussion among coastal First Nations people about taking back control over hunting licenses, control of salmon river? Legally, the possibilities are there.
Yeah. I mean, to me, I think First Nations have always had the authority. I mean, especially in British Columbia, where we haven't signed treaties with any government. We're never conquered in war, or, you know, we never gave it away. So to me, we're going to continue to enforce it. You know, obviously, we want to try and work with, you know, provincial and federal governments on some of these issues. But yeah, so we are on the government-to-government tables now, having a lot of discussions right now. But whether they agree or not, we'll continue to enforce it on the ground, and we'll continue to be there. And I was really hoping for a trophy hunter in our territory this year, just to prove a point, but it didn't quite happen. But you know, to me, I think we've done our due diligence as a level of government. We've collected that bear, you know, all the science work, you know, we've done the economics, we've done poll of British Columbians, where 91% of people now oppose, you know, these sort of practices. So I don't know where it's left to go. We'll continue to force it. I think we're getting closer, and I think, but it's going to continue to take, you know, a lot of different groups, you know, whether it's Raincoast or whether it's Spearfoot Research Foundation or communities, you know, just to continue to keep the pressure up in order to end these kind of things. So.
Would you support a provincial referendum to ban trophy hunting?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, I mean, I wish I could get up and speak for all of British Columbia when it comes to bears, but I can't, because all of our research is really focused on the Great Bear, and what I hope happens is that we end trophy hunting in the Great Bear Rainforest, and then that's contagious, that other regions will start to protect it, and it'll be kind of, you know, it'll be contagious. So that's what I hope happens. But I think British Columbians have spoke very loud and clear, and I think there was one poll that was done in 2003 that I think at that time it was 79% of British Columbians did not support trophy hunting. And we did a poll, part of our bear working group, and that number had climbed to 87% of people didn't support it. And that number now, it was a more recent poll that was done by another group that came up to 91% of people did not support it. So I think numbers are growing, and I think the issues are really starting to you know, spread. And I think things like social media are really starting to allow people to have access in terms of reading what's going on in our backyard, and that's been great. The whole sea seal and lion thing, I mean, that was huge. I mean, to watch that happen, so. Mm-hmm.
Lee,
no. So yeah, the question is, are black bears and white bears identical in terms of protection? No. So I call it bear racism. White bears are protected and black bears are yeah, no.
So spirit bears are protected?
Spirit bears are protected, yeah. You cannot shoot or harvest any spirit bears, but you can harvest a black bear that's carrying that recessive gene that could produce that spirit bear. So, so yeah, black bears can be hunted. Okay, I think that's it. And I'll be around to take any other questions later on. And so thank you very much for your time.